Yes, they have given an extraordinary introduction of mine, which I never expected. Really feeling proud today that I am being introduced by someone. I only remember on one more another occasion when my son introduced me when I was selected as a Lions Club president. Definitely, Sana and Jay, you deserve a big applaud and big thanks from my side. Welcome to you all, guys. It's really nice and wonderful to be here. Yes, to introduce myself to some of you who probably are hearing me for the first time, I am Sandeep, and probably those who knows me, I am hardworking, I am caring, I am disciplined, I am jovial, I am loving, and I am strict. Things which I expect to fall in place, I expect them to fall in place. But yes, I always ensure that people who work with me, people who are around me, are always enthusiastic. That's what is probably my nature. Yes, by degree, I'm a BTech graduate, not a very extraordinary degree, just a BTech graduate from Osmania University, Chaitanya Bharti Institute of Technology. And after my graduation, I would say I was lucky enough that my higher studies in US could not happen. My visa got rejected. And I can say that I'm lucky enough because only then I actually started Deccan Soft. I could actually start Deccan Soft and be at place where I am and my team are today. Yes, I really feel also lucky because if I would have gone to US, I would not have got a chance to be with my dad in his last days. 4 years back when he was detected with pancreatic cancer, we knew the destiny. And I would say that was the best moments of my life, the 1 year which I have invested upon him. Yes, I stayed together with my brother. It's a joint family. We are total in all 9 people headed by my mother. My wife is also into IT. My brother is into business. His wife is a doctor, homeopathy doctor. We have 2 children. He has 1 son, 1 daughter. I have 2 children. The first one is already probably going to succeed me. He started his first step into IT. His name is Naman. As probably Sana has told you, they are chosen names, N-A-M-A-N, Naman and Nayan. Both are palindromes. There was a philosophy behind that. I wanted to keep the names simple, like Ram. The name is simple and the life, I wanted to keep the names simple. That was the philosophy behind and that's how the names were chosen. Yes, in the year 1997, I started my first job, which was as a lab coordinator in one of the software training centers in Hyderabad. And probably I would say that is the learning ground which I got. That is the place where I learned how to deal with people, how to handle students, understood being in lab, what is the requirement of a student when they come to learning their problems and what kind of solutions. Of course, after around 8 months of hard working, actually I started my job with just a salary of rupees 2000. But the learning was extraordinary. The returns were extraordinary, may not be in financial terms, but in all other aspects. I would still not forget those days when I used to go to the office and open the office at around 7 a.m. and probably stay there almost till evening, 6 and 7 p.m. and come back home, take rest and next day be ready. Learn a lot. I was teaching VC++ at that point of time. And because of some internal politics, I had to quit that job, fortunate again, and I was free, wanted to do something. That is the time when Microsoft actually introduced certification exams in the industry. And I just did not have second thought. That's my destiny. I started preparing aggressively for the certification exam on VC++. Fortunately, I got MSDN documentation at that time. Huge volume of content. But as much as I could read, I read. and very first attempt pass. Probably I was the first in Hyderabad and Secunderabad to clear that certification. Rather, the concept of certification came to Hyderabad and I was probably the first at that time to write and master it. Then what? The confidence was huge, huge. Already had some teaching background, and in the blood only, the DNA was already there, a business. Never wanted to do a full-time job, it was very clear. Started Deccan Soft with just 8 students, with a small advertisement I gave in a local newspaper, with the confidence that I can teach because I had a certificate. Yes, in a couple of months, my colleague Rahul joined me, who is now also a director in Deccan Soft with me. And then what? We never turned back. Started teaching VC++, went on to Visual Basic, that was the demand there at that time. The world moved towards web. I continued with the Microsoft stream, ASP I took over, Active Server Pages. Probably I was again the first ones to launch ASP in Twin Cities. Side by side, Rahul was teaching Java, but the demand in year 2000 was so high, even in unintentional case, I was a trap and started teaching Java. I did not want to, but there was no choice. We were conducting around 12 batches of Java in a day together, me and Rahul, probably 100 plus students in each. We had a waiting period of around 1 to 2 months. Students used to just enroll and wait. We were peak in our, I would say, career in terms of the reputation, in terms of the quality of subject. Forte was very clear. We will give quality to the crowd. We will not bother about the duration. There were batches which were even going to the extent of 5 to 6 months. But thought was very clear that we should make a factory of engineers who can easily get a job, and that's what probably got us a reputation. Worked tirelessly, started my career itself with hard work, around 12 hours on an average I used to work daily, and it went on and on. There was no turning back until year 2000 ended, when in 2001 I saw a recession. Yes, that is when I saw, probably the world saw, the IT came down. What we were having around 100 students per batch were shrinking to maybe 3 to 5 students per batch. There was always a thought that I should go back to the family business, which was already running well and good. But then somehow we decided to stay on. Both of us kept going, myself and Rahul. And then came an opportunity where Microsoft launched .NET. They were only talking about .NET, and when it was in beta, I actually started teaching .NET. And I'm pretty sure those people who did C# with me from my first batch are probably at least VPs and managers and directors in a lot of organizations today. Yes, only in 2002 when .NET came up, we had full-fledged batches of .NET. And 2003, the market was back again. It's a so well saying, what goes down will go up and what goes up will go down. I've seen a lot of swings in my life, ups and downs. But in 2003, when it was in peak, we again started teaching .NET. This time it was reverse. Even Rahul was teaching .NET along with me. And then we again hit by another recession in 2008. New, got experience already, how to handle recession, survived a couple of years. This time, probably for us, it was not as bad as 2001 recession. And when the whole thing improved, we saw that .NET new versions have come, a lot of new services were released. We went on to the next level. And also by the time Deccan Soft started its development, somewhere in 2003, we started our development, and I still remember the first project which our team did was for $3. But trust me, we went on with the development. Our customers were so satisfied. For the same customer for whom we did our first project for $3, we continued till last year all the development activities. Hundreds of dollars, thousands of dollars every year we did business with them. Yes, I always believed in starting from where I can. I didn't want ever to make everything perfect and then start. Even this conference, for that matter, is on the same lines. I told the team, let us start from wherever we are. And that's what I tell many of the people who come around me. Don't wait for everything to become perfect. It will never happen. With whatever resources we have, with whatever time we have, let us start and keep improving on a day-to-day basis. That's how my lifestyle, my philosophy has been. Yes, though the development center which we started in Deccan Soft did not do as much as probably the training did, but trust me, the kind of experience which I got working with the development team, working on projects, directly imparted knowledge to me, which was essentially important in teaching. That's where I actually became different trainer from others. Teaching was never considered as a white collar job. People came to teaching because they did not get development. But my case was reverse. I started teaching, learned a lot of subject, and then did development. So anything in development, given a problem, I was always having a solution. So a very important lesson to the people who probably are listening to me. If you're not on job today, treat that as an opportunity and learn the subject as much as you can. Because once you get a job, it's going to be very difficult to learn. You will not have time. Time will be ample only when you are doing nothing. So recession was a boon period to me when I started recording my courses. Just because one student wanted to go back to USA and listen to my classes offline, on a humble request of her, I started recording my C-sharp classes. And because I had the recorded material and I already had a development team, we built our own website, which you today call it as best.nettraining.com. At that time, the name was very catchy. The moment you type best.nettraining.com, that would be the first website which would automatically pick up on the Google search engine, first to come. So the team was there, was doing the development of best.net training, the videos I made, and we had an excellent platform for selling our courses. So development, though, was definitely not a very big success in Deccan Soft, but as always complimented, I always used to pick up the smart people from my class and hire them into the development. They used to work with us for a couple of years, go back into the industry with high experience, and even today there are so many who are in touch with me with the gratitude that they started their career with Deccan Soft and doing extraordinary in what they are. Yesterday only one person called me from USA and said thank you because he purchased a home in US. Harinath Reddy, his name is. Only yesterday he called me. I mean, these things give a lot of satisfaction. Yes. Coming to my technology background, I always believed in teaching what is the need of the hour. I never said I'm only going to teach VC++ or I'm only going to teach Visual Basic. I always shifted with time. The lesson which I learned from this is love technology. But don't love so much that you remain permanent with it. When you know there is something better coming up, be ready to switch, be ready to upgrade. That is what is very important, guys. Only when we are ready to upgrade, we remain latest. Yes, I am 45 now, and I very strongly feel confident when I teach. And the reason is, I keep learning on a daily basis. I don't think there goes any day where I did not learn something new. A lot of people ask me, Sandeep, where do you get all this energy from? See, I am among those guys who have made my profession as my passion. Teaching today is my passion. Only when I teach, I get energy. Like a sportsman, when he plays, he gets energy. A footballer, when he runs on the ground, he never gets tired. When I teach, I don't get tired. Yeah, there are cases where the physical body needs some rest, but teaching is like my habit, my passion, and I love challenges. Challenges motivate me. I don't, it's good or bad. My family says, Sandeep, you get into unnecessary challenges many times. I pick up courses in corporate training when I don't even know what it is. I pick up. But when I have to deliver, I will be the best. I compile my material in such a beautiful way that I hear awesome words about the content. Only yesterday, I finished one of the corporate trainings for Ericsson, and at the end, I heard one sentence which I still remember. Sandeep, your material is gold. And that gives me so much pride. Wow, yes, it was a return on my effort. A word of praise was a return on the effort which probably I and my team put. And same I expect from you people today. I would definitely would love to hear from you people today certain things about how you have benefited and how you can make this whole thing more better in coming days. Yes, I would definitely love to talk about my Azure journey. It was .NET all I was teaching, and only by accident when somebody who was teaching SharePoint left Deccan Soft, I had no choice but to start teaching myself the course SharePoint. That is the point I shifted from .NET to SharePoint. I would not say shift, I started parallelly teaching SharePoint. That is the time I started doing something different than simple programming. I started teaching SharePoint administration. The market of SharePoint got boom, taught a lot of people. And then now I have, yes, .NET, SharePoint, already in my belt, certified in all of them, Microsoft certification. By this time, I already acquired Microsoft certified trainer. Deccan Soft became silver partner. What next was the question. And in the year 2015, Satya Nadella, the CEO of Microsoft, made a big, bold statement that the annualized commercial cloud revenue would reach 20 billion by the year end 2018. I treat that as a bold statement because at that point of time, the revenue was just 6.3 billion. Yes, we all very well know this, and Microsoft actually achieved that goal 1 year earlier. In 2017 itself, they achieved that goal. So it was very clear that Azure is the way to go forward. I aligned myself to Azure. I aligned Deccan Soft courses to Azure, and I was seeing Microsoft is also doing something very similar. Trusted Microsoft as always. Started teaching Microsoft Azure. Of course, my primary focus was initially Azure development. But as I was exploring development, I realized there are certain things which I'm missing upon. There are certain things which I would definitely want to know when I have an opportunity to exploit the cloud. And that is when I started digging into the administration of Azure, the infrastructure aspect of Azure. And trust me, guys, today I am a Microsoft certified Azure administrator, Azure developer, Azure architect. I'm a DevOps engineer. And all these things are so easy today because of the cloud availability to the people. We don't have to see the physical hardware to practice them. And now I know this 360 degree view of Azure, the level of my teaching, the level of my sharing knowledge with the participant has become pretty high. Yes, some people say that it is literally mesmerizing to listen to my subject. I'm sure some of you would agree and put it in the chat too. Your experience about how you would like, how do you feel when you listen to the classes which are delivered by me and the trainers of Deccan Soft. We already got into online training few years back, literally closed our classroom training. And what? COVID probably was a very bad thing which happened to the world, but somehow our business got aligned to the need of the hour. This year has been the best of my career so far. We have done already in the current financial year more than the double amount of business what would we would do it in an average year. Delivering so many online trainings to the retail crowd and as well as to the corporates. I do almost every day I'm teaching corporate nowadays. For last 1 month, including Saturdays and Sundays, I have been training almost 7 to 8 hours regularly. And this is my schedule going to be till at least this year end. And why? The reason is simple. Cloud, Azure, the need of the hour. So my strong recommendation to all those people who have experience in the industry working on .NET, have been working on networking, have been working on database administration, have been working on security. Guys, it's the time we all raise and ensure that we have enough amount of cloud knowledge. You choose. You choose between Azure, AWS, GCP. It's like Coca-Cola, Pepsi and thumbs up. What you choose, it's your choice. But definitely you have to be one of be with one of them. Yeah, because I had some inclination towards Microsoft always, I picked up Azure. I have no knowledge about AWS and GCP. Probably that is wrong, but I got so much focused into Azure that I just worked on it. And today I would say I'm literally filled with Azure knowledge so much that anybody asks me for a solution, it will be just ready on top of my head. The reason I'm telling this to all of you people, if you haven't started your career in Azure, it's the time. It's the time you raise. Otherwise, very soon you are going to feel outdated. Very, very, very important, guys. Before something becomes an emergency, let us act. For many of you, learning Azure today may not be an emergency, it might be a choice. But why do it when it is emergency? If I can be healthy, I don't have to go into an emergency to a doctor. Definitely no. So yes, my suggestion to you is, whatever role you have, if you are a network engineer, choose something like Azure infrastructure, Azure administration. If you are a software developer, maybe you are a Java developer, maybe you are a .NET developer, Python developer, PHP developer, get into Azure development. Learn those services which will make your application highly productive. Let you be an architect. If you are not capable enough to align your architect knowledge to Azure services, you are already outdated. You might be working with data engineering tools. You might be working with AI, ML. AI, ML have been made possible today because of so much cloud services being easily available. Otherwise, I learned about AI and ML in 95 when I was graduating. That was the topic on which I did my presentation in the college. But we know we are talking rubbish It was nothing which was possible in real time. And today, AI ML is so simple. Just because of cloud. Cloud is there and will be there. It will become as simple as operating system. How much knowledge you need today for operating system? That will be the analogy I would take if you want to learn about cloud. Yes, with so much deep already into cloud, specifically Azure, there was some gap which I always had. What is that I'm going to do to make Deccan Soft remembered by the people? Right now, I am teaching and a small team is teaching. But how many of the people are really taking the benefit? Same time, I was already being invited for delivering my lectures as a speaker in some of the sessions of C-Sharp Corner, online sessions. I also had a chance to participate as one of the speakers along with so many big dignitaries who have literally been founders of C-Sharp in C-Sharp Corner conferences. And that literally hit me hard. What is that I'm doing? How will I be remembered? How will Deccan Soft be remembered forever? Yes, that is when the thought of doing a portal on Azure came into the mind. Immediately called my team into my cabin and said, let's start thinking of doing some portal. Let's move our focus only from teaching to something more. And then we started hunting for names. With so much of deliberation, thoughts, discussion, we came up with name AzureA2Z.com, and fortunate were to find out it's available. Immediately blocked it. And then what? The name already gave us the roadmap. We wanted to give something to the community of Azure, which probably no other website in the world is giving it. Of course, I would not say Microsoft is there in that level. But other than that, we wanted to contribute in every possible ways. We wanted to build a website which talks about the near events which are happening on Azure around the world, jobs which are available on Azure. We wanted to keep the people ready by providing interview questions on various topics. We are now working on ability to even write and make articles public on Azure. We have forums where the questions on Azure can be asked. We have a provision where we provide certification assistance. You can go to our site, find out direct links to the relevant pages when you want to prepare some guidance for certification. We created our own question bank for Azure certification. And etc. I'm sure it's an ongoing process, but the thought is very clear. We should bring everything about Azure under one umbrella. Yes, this was just a thought, I would say same time last year. Almost same time, it was just a thought. And today, after 1 year, I see this as a reality and feel proud along with my team to present a conference on the same platform. We already have more than 10,000 registered members on this website. Already in just span of 1 year of a thought to what it is today. Yeah, we actually went live only sometime in June. Good amount of traffic on the site. Yes, we are also learning there. We are adding new features, new modules. Like my policy, start with what we have and then proceed and keep improving. I'm pretty sure going forward, many millions are going to benefit out of the contribution which we are making. Yes, my dream come true. Maybe I would be there, not there. The developers who have actually initiated will be there, not there. But the world will remember Deccan Soft because of Azure A2Z contribution. I know we have miles to go. But it's going to be an ongoing journey. This is just the first step in the direction of inviting you people to take the benefits which we are giving to the community back for so many things we have taken from in last 23 years. So yes, I proudly present to you this particular special event for all the family members of Deccan Soft of Azure A2Z, the conference 2020. Yes, there are certain announcements which I would definitely love to make before I leave you people here. As a special contribution, every weekend, right from the coming weekend, we are going to introduce hands-on session for all the people across the globe. We will share the link with you. We will let you join our Microsoft Teams session and practice any one topic along with the expert. Maybe creation of virtual machine and distribution of load using load balancer. Step by step, one of our team members will do it and you would do it together. Complete hands-on session. Yes, there will not be any theory, just the practical, so that one feels confident in certain important topics. It will be a 2 hours of session which is going to be conducted on every Saturday, where we are going to allow all members across the A2Z community. Everybody who has registered on A2Z will be welcome to join the session and learn together with my team member. And for gold members, a premium package, a premium membership of Deccan Soft, a similar session also will be conducted on Sunday. But that would be restricted to just the gold members, the premium Deccan Soft service, which gives you access to all our courses, something very close to my heart. Definitely a worth deal if you have not looked at it. I would want you to look at the gold membership and the benefits you are going to get with it. Yes, another big announcement which we are making now is very soon, probably after tomorrow, from 1st of December, A2Z is going to be ready for public contribution. You can write articles and publish there. You can post interview questions. You can post forum articles. You can reply to questions on the forum. And every contribution you are going to make, there will be points rewarded to you. We will see how these points can be redeemed. But definitely, every month there is going to be a person who will be rewarded suitably, whoever gets the highest point. Just a motivation factor to do contribution. And we are going to have a leaderboard where your name, your contribution, everything is going to be summarized, which you can probably refer to in the future too. Yes, these are the two major announcements which I wanted to make on this special day for Deccan Soft and its community. Learning is ongoing process. Those who have listened to me before already know this. There are only two ways of learning. Learn with self-experience. Learn from others' experience. Every learning is about making mistakes and not repeating them. My lesson to you, my message to you all is, keep learning when it is optional. Don't wait for it to become an emergency. I once again present to you all this wonderful set of speakers who are going to talk on various aspects of Azure, right from AI to ML to serverless computing to security, data engineering, and the data presentation. 6 back-to-back sessions, guys. Reap the benefit. Don't forget to participate in the quizzes and showcase your name. Rewards are okay, but being on top should be the habit. Thank you and very best of luck to all of you.